Good morning to you all. From a Dutch winter landscape aboard the Asmara. Unlike what you are used to from me, this is not a video about part of my voyage, but it's certainly related to it. On my last return trip, somewhere in September 22, just moored in the Netherlands, on an island at the Lake Lauwersmeer, where I found excessive oil leakage during an engine check, which was caused by the velvet drive, the engine's reverse clutch. To prevent further dirty oil mess, I placed a washing up bowl under it. From then on, I did have to top up every few engine hours. I docked in Friesland at a shipyard specialized in my type of engine and drive, where a mechanic had investigated it and concluded that it needed to be taken out and overhauled. They didn't have the time the first 2 months, so advice was, take it out yourself and bring it this winter here for overhaul. My engine is a Ford Lehman 2715 Echo, a six-cylinder 120 horsepower engine with 6,500 hours on the clock. The velvet drive is a model AS15.72 Charlie with a gear ratio of 2.91:1, a Warner gear division BorgWarner velvet drive. In this short video, I show you some stages of that removal, although I can't film and work at the same time. So you see some pictures and finally the drive is out. To help the viewers who face the same problem, I made a manual for this, where I explain step by step how to remove and what to watch out for. At the end of this video, you get to see a link pointing to a page on my website for the PDF manual. It's in English, but that shouldn't be a problem for most Dutch people. I hope I can share my knowledge with you, and if you are not yet a subscriber, click the red button to subscribe. So this is all, and happy watching. Here you see the 27 series, and on the right button you see the drive. In this picture, the number 1 and number 2 is the velvet drive. You see the hoses that comes from the velvet drive, which goes to the oil cooler. You see the engine studs, which have to be completely removed. Further on this picture, you see at number 3, where it is attached to the propeller shaft. Now, in the next picture, you see a little bit more in detail the engine studs. And this is the jack I used to lift up the engine to remove the engine studs. Here is a picture of the jack underneath the engine. As you can see, with wooden pieces to support the engine to lift up to remove the jacks, studs. The studs are still here attached. The oil hoses are already disconnected, and at this stage the whole drive is coming loose, and finally with a strap and a sling to support it further, we have to remove the propeller shaft aft. By doing that, unbolting the thrust bearing, and then you can rotate and move the shaft at least the 5 inches aft to make sure that the velvet drive is clear to get out. And this is a set. I have a manual to see this, to do this step by step. So I hope that I can help people who want to do the same thing. Finally, the last picture is where the velvet drive is removed, and you can see that the propeller shaft is a little bit aft, and that is to get clearance. There is the velvet drive as it is completely removed. Now, I should say, go to my manual for details. Thank you for watching.